How to deal with the errors in Snowflake. Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see how to solve the errors that we get in Power BI. What are the Snowflake keywords in order to solve the errors in Snowflake that we are going to see in it? So in my previous videos, I have shown how to use the copy command in order to load the data from our external stage into Snowflake. I have also shown how to transform the data in different various examples. Today, let us see how to deal with the errors that we get in Snowflake. We are human beings, we get multiple errors. We get multiple errors in our day-to-day work. We do a lot of mistakes, we do a lot of errors in our regular life, with ourselves, with family, with many things. Every problem, every error that we get, though it is a technical work, though it is a non-technical work, there is a probable solution. Though we get a problems in our life, we try to solve it. Though we get problems in our relationships, we try to solve them. In the same way, though we get the errors, though we get the multiple bugs or errors or whatever we get in the technical work, in any technology you take, there is some probable solution. So in the same way, in our Snowflake, what are the errors we are going to get with the examples that we take here in this video, and how to solve them very easily, that I am going to walk you through this one. So let's work on it. Before directly showing you the error, let me create a new stage. Earlier we have created one external stage. So now I am creating a new stage with the keyword create or replace a stage, and sample DB and external stage AWS stage. This was my previous stage. So now I am creating with a new name called error X. And from where I am getting this particular stage or the data that we have in this stage? From this AWS S3 bucket Snowflake 4. And this is my URL from my AWS that I have taken it to. So if I create this particular stage, so let me create this particular stage first. As soon as I create it, you can see that the stage error X is successfully created. Now let me show you what are the files that we have in this particular stage that we have created. So for this, we use the keyword called list. So that's where I am executing list with my entire stage name. So there are two particular files, CSV files. One is order details error. Another one is order details error. Here, I have two particular files in my new stage that I have created. Let me create a new table. Let me create a new table where in this new table that I have created or I am about to create, in this new table, I have to load the data from my new stage that I have created. So the same process we follow how we have seen it in our recent videos. So what am I going to do? I am going to create a table. And what is my table name? Orders example. For that I have taken a short form EX. I am creating some columns in it. Order ID column, amount column, profit column, quantity column, category column and subcategory column and so on. So let me create a table. I am creating a table. So my table order EX is successfully created. When I am telling that in my new stage, there are two CSV files in our new stage that I have created. One is order details error and I have named the other CSV file as order details error 2, because we should not have two files in the same name. The point here is that in this data or in these files that we have tried in order to get the data or copy the data from our external stage into Snowflake, as you can see, the profit, which is a integer data type, I have done a very small change in it. That is, when I'm telling that the profit column is integer, it means that it will allow only the integer values, which are numbers. Now, in the place of number, I have written it in a numerical way. In the place of 1000, I have written O-N-E space T-H-O-U-S-A-N-D, 1000. So, that is a mistake. Let us see that this particular mistake will be identified by Snowflake or not. Okay. So, for this, first I have created a table. Now, I have to copy this, load this data from my external stage into Snowflake. So, what is the file that I am choosing? I am choosing my order details error CSV file, where I have to copy the data into it. So, if I execute it, so when I am trying to execute this copy data, as I told you that the numeric value 1000 is not recognized. The reason is that the profit is integer value. In integer value, you cannot add the characters. So for this reason, even this particular error itself is giving us one suggestion. What is that suggestion? If you would like to continue loading the data when an error is occurred, then use the skip file or continue for the on error option. This is the error that we have got. So it is telling us, though you got the error, if you want to execute or continue loading the data, then we have to use two keywords for on error that we have got it, which is skip file or continue. It is giving us a suggestion. So though if you see C language, Java, Python or something, you will not find these kind of suggestions. Now we have to find or sort the whole error by ourselves. So now what? Let us do it. Let us validate the table that we have created first. So we have successfully created our table, which is order ID, amount, profit, quantity, category and subcategory. As you can see it, the table is ready. Okay. Now, as it gave me the suggestion that I can use the continue or skip file as my on error option in order to continue my loading, I will use the same suggestion in order to go with it. So for this, what I'm doing, I'm using this copy command with the on error option equal to continue. What I'm doing, I'm using that continue. Though I got the error, let me continue the loading. So let us see whether it gets loaded or not. So for this, what I'm doing, I am using the on error option here and I'm executing it. So when I'm executing it, it is telling me that it is not fully loaded. It is partially loaded. It is partially loaded. If you even see that the rows that we have are 1500, but the rows which are loaded are only 1498. It means that there are errors, two errors. How many errors are seen? Two errors are seen. And what is the error? The first error is numeric value 1000 is not recognized. So where do we have the errors? In the first line, in the my CSV file. So this is a very clear indication what exactly it is giving it to me. Okay. So when I have 1500 rows, my only 1498 rows are loaded. So I have seen error in my two rows. Okay, that's what it is telling it to me. Now, so let us validate the results and see that whether we have got the data in it or not. Yes, we have got it. As you can see, we have got the data into our new table that we have created. Okay, now the point is that let me, as I have got two errors, earlier there were 1500 rows, out of which only 1498 rows are loaded. There are two rows which are still not loaded and are missing because there are errors in those two particular rows, because there are character values in those two rows where it should have integer values. Now what I'm going to do, I am going to truncate my table. What does this truncate do? It will remove all the data from the table. Whatever the data that I have copied and loaded in my order X table, it will remove everything from that particular table. So what I will do, I will remove it so that we can load it from fresh. So I am executing it. Statement executed successfully. If I show it to you, I don't have anything. I don't have any single data in my particular order X table. If I use count as my keyword as a function, so that I would like to see how many rows I have, it is zero. Okay, we have zero rows in it. Now the point is, what I'm going to do, I am not considering only one CSV file. In this copy command, I have used only one CSV file, which is order details error. Now what I'm going to do, I am using another information here, including my order details error CSV file. I am also including order details error to CSV file. Okay, I am using two files. Let me come to the point why. So here, earlier I have used the on error option as continue. Now I am using the on error option as abort statement, which is the default value for the on error, though we give it, though we don't give it in Snowflake. So what does exactly this abort statement do? You might have a question. See, abort statement, it means that whenever an error is occurred, just the loading will not at all happen. Whenever the error is occurred, the loading will not happen. In where the loading will not happen? The loading will not happen in the table that we have created. From where? From the new stage that we have created. Okay. So no data will be copied in our table. So what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to use abort statement, which is the default one in Snowflake. Now the point is that if the data is not getting loaded using the error CSV file, order detail error CSV file, at least it should be loaded using the another CSV file. That is the reason I'm using the two CSV files here in my files option. So now I am trying to copy and load it. Let us see what we will get it. Again, we will get the error. Okay. Again, we will get the error. Okay. Why we are getting the error? The reason for getting the error is that we are using abort statement. What abort statement is doing? It is not letting us to load any value in our table. So the data will not get copied. The data will not get copied. Now the point is that what I'm trying to do, if I try to execute it also in order to see my order X table, there is no data in it. There is no data copied in it because we have used abort statement. Now let us do one thing. As in our previous suggestions, Snowflake told us either you can use continue or either you can use skip file. Earlier we have seen by using continue and by using only one CSV file, what happened? Out of 1500 rows, only two rows were missing. Rest 1498 rows were successfully loaded, where we call it as partially loaded. Now using the skip file option, for our on error option, we use skip file and let us try to copy the data into our table using our stage that we have created. So if you see here, in our order details error, the load got failed. As the load got failed from our order details CSV file, the data got loaded with our second CSV file, which is error to CSV file. So that's the reason I am choosing two CSV files here. If you see here, 285 rows are there in my second CSV file, 285 rows were loaded. So 1500 rows were there in the file which got failed, the loading got failed, no errors were loaded. Though I have 1500, no errors were loaded. And we can see that the errors are two. So that's the reason I have chosen two files at once. Now you might have a question, if I have three files, if the data is not coming from that, you can use the rest of the files that you have in our stage. Now if you see it, let me try to execute and show you my whole table order X. You can see that my whole table is successfully visible, where no sort of errors is skipped. Okay, as my first CSV file got error, it is not considering that CSV file and it is skipping it, and it is considering my second CSV file where the data is successfully loaded with all the rows. Alright, so now let me again try to truncate and remove all the values from my table. Again, let me start something fresh with some other another option that I would like to show it to you. Where what I'm going to do it here, I'm going to take the specific number. So how many errors we have in our recent errors? We have 2. Okay, so out of 1500 rows, only 1498 were loaded, only 2 errors were seen. So what I am telling to Snowflake that you can skip the file with the 2 errors. Okay, if you have 3 errors, go with 3. Okay, if you have 4 errors, go with 4. Give the specific number, don't give the range. What I'm doing, I have created a copy command, the same thing, just in the place of skip file, I'm adding underscore 2, which means that I would like to tell to Snowflake that you skip those 2 errors that you have seen in my order detail CSV file and load the data. Okay, let us see what will happen. I'm trying to load it because, again, why I'm trying to load it again? Because I have truncated my particular table. Again, you can see that the error CSV file got failed, loading got failed, and the second CSV file from that, the data has been loaded. As you can see that the error limit that we have set up is 2. Okay, the error limit that I have set up is 2, the 2 that we call it as an error limit, which we have seen it in our previous executions of our copy command. So now the point is that what is the error? Again, the 1000 is not recognized. Okay, the error scenes are 2. So as I am setting up the limit, that limit, what Snowflake is doing, it is telling that yes, there are 2 errors. That's where I am considering my another CSV file, and from there the data has been loaded. And if I again execute it, and if I show it to you, I can see that all the data from my second CSV file, it is successfully copied in my table. So if I would like to use the count, and if I would like to show you how many particular rows we have in our order EX new table, there are 285 rows, which is successful. So when my earlier particular order detail CSV file, in that we have errors, I am getting the information from my second CSV file. That's where I am using 2 CSV files in the same file format option. File format object is a separate topic that I will be telling it to you in my next upcoming videos. So I have considered my 2 CSV files. So when the first CSV file loading is getting failed, the second CSV file data will be copied into our new table that we have created from our external stage. The data where we have it from our external stage. So whenever we are trying to get the data, okay, whenever we are trying to copy the data or load the data, if you are getting some errors in Snowflake, you can use on error option as on error equal to, and you can use the keywords that I have shown it to you. There might be different scenarios while you are working in the real-time companies, but on error is the same keyword that you have to use it in order to work on the errors in order to detect it. So that's where the on error option in Snowflake works out. So I hope you have learned something interesting from this, how to deal with errors in our Snowflake. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.